All right, so good day everyone. So last meeting we discussed about the introduction of computers, and we also discussed about why computer is considered as an electronic device and the functionalities on it, and so with these input devices. So you also I let you give and explain to you I let you explain the why this device is considered as an input device. No, we also discussed about the primary memory, about the RAM, the ROM, and then so pa may lain na tong gidiscuss ana. So katong mga storage devices, no? So the hard disk, the different types of hard disk, the SSD and the HDD. Okay, so this time still we're still on chapter 1. It's still on introduction to computers, but we're now in output devices. Okay, so what is output devices? So output devices is any piece of computer hardware equipment used to communicate the results of data processing carried out by an information processing system. So such as computer, no? So which converts the electronically generated information into human readable form. So, kaning output devices is an opposite of input devices. Since you already know the examples of input devices such as keyboard, the mouse, the scanner, diba? We use that device as a medium for us to communicate sa computer. And then the computer will process it, and then the information na iyang igawas dito dayon sa output devices. So do you have an idea already the examples of output devices before I'm going to show you the examples? So I hope no. So these are the examples of output devices. Of course, we have the monitor. So the monitor will give you the information based on the data you have inputted into the computer. So dito niya igawas sa monitor. So even any type of monitor, so consider that as an output device. So with these printers, no? So makita na itong mga klase-klase ng mga printer. We have the laser, the inkjet, and the dot matrix printer. So what are the difference among this printer? When you say laser printer, ginagamit na siya og toner. Katong powder based na siya. So, munang pag-print sa laser printer, init ang iyang gawas. That's because inito niya ang katong ano, ang powder para i-convert into text or alphanumeric. And then, with this inkjet printer, gagamitan siya mga cartridge. So, si cyan, si black, si cyan, si magenta, and si yellow. And then, si dot matrix, gamitan siya o katong ribbon. So, ang pinaka, affordable na bala niya mismo is si dot matrix because ribbon lang siya. So, dugay siya mahurot. And then, the next one is si inkjet printer. So, mas barato siya compare siya sa laser printer because si laser printer, mahal ang toner ni mo paliton. No? And then, mas dali pagit siya mahurot. But then, if you're going to buy it, kung sa printer alone lang, mas barato si laser printer. Ngano si laser printer man barato kay tungod murag opposite po siya ba? If mahal kaayo ang ihang ang consumable niya, barato po kayang printer. So kani si inkjet printer po, well, dili kayo mahal ang ihang cartridge niya, mga cartridge niya dili kayo nga nakamahal. Sa so, di ba kabantay mo usahay makapalit ra kag 200 plus. Di ba mga 200 plus or 300 plus na mga cartridge sa cyan, sa colored. So, mas tugay pagit siya mahurot. Si dot matrix, medyo mamahal-mahal gin na ang iyahang printer po. But then, mas naka-cheaper po ka sa iyahang pala. Pero normally, si dot matrix, ginagamit na siya sa mga cashiering gani na sa POS. Okay, no? So, kanang mga receipts. So, another example of output device, we have the speaker. No? So, and different mga output devices na considered as kanang mga peripherals pagyapon siya na maghatag siya og information, so like projectors and plotters. So next one is a software. Software is a generic term for organized collections of a computer data and instruction, often broken into two major categories. We have the system software. So kani ga-provide na siya kanang basic non-task-specific functions of the computer. Then, ang kaning application software dayon, which is used by the users, no, to accomplish specific tasks. Okay. So unsa din si system software? So it is responsible for controlling, integrating, and managing the individual hardware components of a computer system so that the other software and the users of the system see it as a functional unit without having to be concerned with a low-level detail such as transferring data from memory to disk or rendering text onto a display. So kani generally ang system software man gyud nga consist na siya og mga operating system and some fundamental utilities, no, such as disk formatters, kanang file managers, display managers, mga text editors, mga user authentication and management tools, and networking and device control software. So muna siya si system software, siya bali siya ang ga-control mismo sa isa ka system. So, sama ng operating system like Windows 10, no? O na pa yung mga DOS. So, mga Linux, muna sila ang mga examples sa system software. Then, si application software, so, is used to accomplish specific tasks, no? Other than just running the computer system. Application software may consist of a single program, such as an image viewer, a small collection of programs, often called a software package, that work closely together to accomplish a task. So, such kana mga, for example, kana mga spreadsheet or text processing system. So, sa mga may example nila ana na kana naagi naka-package na. So, Microsoft Office, no, na siya Excel, na siya PowerPoint. So, pamilain na siya ha, Microsoft Access, Publisher. So, kung mahimo, you want to make a mga certificate, so naana po danan. So, ang application software nagid siya gap ano siya kaning more into specific task gid siya ba na naka-accomplish gani. So kung mag encode ka, so of course you should use a word processing, no, na mga software. Okay, so that's it. Next is comparison. Kung may system software, computer software, or just software is a general term primarily used for digital stored data such as computer programs and other kinds of information read and written by computers. So mga app that comes under computer software, through it has a wide scope. Okay, so application software, put also known as an application or an app, so is a computer software designed to help the user to perform specific tasks. So as you can see here, They are list of examples sa system and sa application. So more gid si system software sa running sa system mismo. So say mga Microsoft Windows, si Linux, si DOS, si Mac OS X, so mga ano, and then the application software, so Opera, Microsoft Word, or mga Microsoft Office, Adobe Photoshop. So daghan pa kayo anything na gagamito nato siya na as a specific task gid siya na application, so gina-considered as application software. So again, si application software, dili nimo siya pwede maguna si application software og install kaysa kang system software. So una gid si system software kay siya ang mother na software mismo sa system. So by installing sa imong ano, sa system software nimo, kailangan pud compatible siya sa imong hardware. Okay, because naagi na siya system requirements na ato ang i-base. Same with application software gapon. So if you're going to buy in the ano kanang sa market, if you're going to buy in the market, is physical ginya na Disney, so normally it is part of the ano, it is being ano list at the back of the disk. So list of the system requirements. So kung if the software requires a minimum of 1 gig memory, so make sure nakamit ka na ni requirement. That's the tendency if you're going to force to install your software sa imuhang computer na wala nagmeet niya. So tendency mag dili gid siya, no, either dili siya mo run mag-error or dagan kaayo or hinay kaayo ang imong ano or dili gid sa mo process ang installation. So, next one is the interaction. So, generally, use do not interact with system software as it works in the background. And then, for the application software, users always interact with application software while doing different activities. Because si system software, siya namang gid mismo ang nagdala. Okay? Siya ang ga-manage mismo, ga-govern siya sa system mismo, sa imong hardware. And then, si application software dayon, daghan gid kaayo ka kana mga specific tasks ana na dayon. Okay? So next is the dependency. So system software can run independently of the application software. Okay? So of course no, as long as compatible siya sa requirements. And then si application software cannot run without the presence of the system software. Just like what I said earlier that you should install first the system software, right after that then you can install the application software but as long as you meet the system requirements. So, ingana siya. So, next one is the unit of measurement. Okay? So, storage of storage measurement. So, the basic unit used in computer data storage is called a bit or a binary digit. Computers use these little bits, no? So, which are composed of ones and zeros. So, to do things and talk to other computers. So, all your files, for instance, are kept in the computer as binary files and translated into words and pictures by the software, so which also ones and zeros. So, this two number system good is called a binary number system. So, since it has only two numbers in it, so the decimal number system in contrast has 10 unique digits, so 0 through 9. So, that's because this computer can only understand 0 and 1. Okay, sa mga binary yang ginasabot. Because dili na siya maingon na siya kasabot siya English, dili. Bali, ang nasabtan niya is yung binary digit, okay, si 0 and 1. So, kani si binary digit, naan siya translator, no? I-translate niya into alphanumeric. So, actually, naan siya conversion, good. So, ang kaning pag-convert. So, that the computer will understand the command that you inputted into the computer. So, katong imong command ni mo, of course, we use English, kay mo man atong language na to. Then, si computer dayon, i-convert niya into binary system, and then, sabton din to niya ang unsang gusto na command ang imuhang ang ginapasabot. Okay? So, this is a computer storage units. So, we have the bit, that's 0 or 1. So, kilobyte is 1,000, that's equivalent to 1,024 bytes. Ang isa ka megabyte is equivalent to 1,024 kilobytes and a gigabyte is 1,024 megabytes and terabyte, so is equivalent to 1,024 gigabytes. So, inga na siya, no? So, these are the examples, no? So, kung isa ka bit, it answers yes or no question. So, a 1 byte is a number from 0 to 255. And 90 bytes, so enough to store a typical line of text from a book. So, you have an idea already na yun sa day, for example, mag-type ka sa Word, di ba? Sa Word. And then, the more data pages and text na itong i-input dito sa mismo sa isa-isa ka application, kagabugat day po day ang ano, ang yung capacity po niya. So, muda ko po ang iyang bytes niya. So, ang about one page of text, it is equivalent to 9 kilobyte. And then, 120 kilobyte, the text of a typical pocketbook. So, ang 3-minute minute song daw, it's equivalent to 3 MB. Then, ang CD-ROM, it has 650 to 900 MB. And then, the 1 gigabyte, that is 114 minutes of uncompressed CD quality audio. And then 8 to 16 gigabytes is the size of a normal flash drive. So for the speed measurement, the speed of a central processing unit is measured by hertz, no? So which is present a CPU cycle. So the speed of the CPU is known as a computer speed. So again, just like what I said last meeting, so nagipun siya ano isa po na siya na iyahang ano indicator po niya na ang performance sa isa ka computer. So kung maayo ang imong CPU or gusto ako ang imong hertz nimo sa imong gigamit na CPU katong mga Core i7, Core i5, mapaspas po dang imuhang ang ano ang computer speed nimo. Okay, so ang 1 hertz is a ano is equivalent to 1 cycle per second. So 1 megahertz is a 1 million cycle per second or 1000 hertz, no? So 1 gigahertz is 1 billion cycles per second or 1000 megahertz, okay? Or 10,000 megahertz. So we're now in a computer's classification. So when you say personal computer, that is a small, no, or a single user computer based on a microprocessor. So kani mga computers can be generally classified by size, no, and a power as follows. So though there is a considerable overlap, no, so kani in addition ang PC to the microprocessor. So kani siyang ginagamit na to na ano kana mga desktop computers, no, that is considered as a personal computer. So naa siya keyboard for para as an input device, and a monitor para hatag siya og output or displaying information, and a storage device for saving data. Okay, so next is ang workstation. So a workstation is a powerful or single user computer. So a workstation is like a personal computer, but it has a more powerful microprocessor and a higher quality monitor. So mura gipun siya og ano personal computer, but then the specification is high, no? Compare nimo sa personal computer. Next one is a mini computer. So it is a multi-user computer capable of supporting from 10 to hundreds of users simultaneously. Then ang mainframe, so a powerful multi-user computer capable of supporting many hundreds of thousands of users simultaneously. So sa mainframe mo mga big companies ang gagamit ani. Okay? So with this supercomputer, so extremely fast computer that can perform hundreds of millions of instructions per second. So muni yung mga pictures niya, no, sa mainframe computer. So usually mga big companies ang gamit ani na makaya niya na dili gid mag log. So mga mini computer, specific task si mini computer, no, si server computer and the microcomputer. Microcomputer is also called personal computer. Kanang ginagamit na to ng mga desktop computer. Okay, so there. Next one is laptops and smartphone computers. So okay, so a laptop is a battery or AC powered personal computer, no, that can be easily carried and used in a variety of locations. So kani si laptop, many laptops mangyud are designed na to have all the functionality of a desktop computer. So which means that they can generally run the same software and open the same types of file. So actually si laptop mura gid gyapon ni siya og si desktop computer, but then portable lang gid siya. Then AC powered po ni siya. So pwede nimo mo charge, pwede po nimo siya matangtang. So kay naman siya battery. Yeah. So however, some laptops, so such as netbooks or kung mang sacrifice some functionality in order to even more portable. So the more put siya kaning mas sensitive lang si laptop, no, compared to desktop computers. That's because if you spill water sa imong keyboard, so daghan kaayo mga hardware na maapektuhan pod. Unlike sa desktop computers, mas cheaper mangid siya compared sa laptops because makabalo na kagani, madali na nimo mailisan, dili mga damay tanan. Okay? Unlike sa si laptop or si netbook. Okay? So, si netbook po, so is a type of laptop that is designed to be even more portable, so mas gaan kay siya. So, netbook are often cheaper than laptops or desktops. So, mas cheaper gid si netbook. So, dili pa sabot na ahay noon, kani si laptop, mas expensive ni siya compare sa desktop. So, if you're going to compare same specification sa desktop and sa laptop, pero, but then, same specification siya, yung hardware requirements, yung hardware specification. But then, mas expensive gapon si laptop, no? Even same specification. That's because appeal namang gitanan dito ang imong ano, kanang portable siya, so napon siya designing ana. Okay? So, si mobile device, kanipun si mobile device, so it's basically any handheld computer, no? It is designed to be extremely portable. So, often fitting in the palm of your hand or in your pocket. So, daghan naman kay taingani karon, talos naman siguro tanan. So, some mobile devices are more powerful, no? And they allow you to do many of the same things you can do in a desktop or laptop. Or a laptop computer. So, this includes the tablet computers or e-readers and smartphones. So, makita na to na kani mga mobile devices manggit karon. Daghan na kaayo functionality niya na makaya gapon sa isa ka mobile device, no? So, as long as the more expensive, the more features ang imong ma-enjoy. Okay, so we could also edit sa ano sa using PowerPoint. So dagan kay ka mabuhat sa Google Classroom, you could do it actually. So dagan kay imong mabuhat kay samot na karon na mga smartphones or mga mobile devices si nag-upgrade. Okay? So the more features, the more pagdaga expensive. So si tablet computer like laptops, tablets computers are designed to be portable, no? So, however, they provide a very different computing experience. The most obvious difference is that the tablet computers don't have keyboards or touchpads. Instead, the entire screen is touch sensitive, allowing you to type on a virtual keyboard and use your finger as a mouse pointer. So, just like what I discussed last meeting, katong mga touch screen. So, considered as input and output device. Okay. So, mga tablet computers manggood is are mostly designed for consuming media, no? And they are kind of optimized for tasks like web browsing, watching videos, so magbasa kag mga e-books and playing games. So, for many people, regular computers like a desktop or laptop is still need in order to use some programs. So, kung uban gud na gamit gyapon sila og mga desktop or laptop na mas dali nila i-navigate or magtrabaho kay usahay man gyud, the more kagamay mas lisod kay siya lihukon. So, si smartphone pod is a powerful mobile phone that is designed to run a variety of applications, no? In addition to phone service. So, ingana. So, they are basically the small tablet, no? Or small tablet computers, and they can be used for web browsing gapon, so watching videos, reading ebooks, playing games, and a lot of more. So, si smartphones is halos namang gid karon, especially if you're a student or a professional, murag ano gid kay siya, bagay gid kay mga smartphones sa atua. Okay, para dili na kailangan na magpalit pa pag ano. Pero but then, as I said earlier, na mas siya gapon usahay kung mag Adobe Photoshop ka or mag na kay mga thesis name mo or projects, mas sana ginang mas komportable ka sa imong gina gamit. Okay? But then, wala kay choice do dito gid ka magantos na lang gid ang ato. But then, berdili ni siya mga mga barato, pero mga mahal gyapon ni silang tanan. Next one is data, information, and knowledge. Okay? So data, so facts and figures which relay something specific, no, but which are not organized in any way and which provide no further information regarding patterns and context. So kanisi, kung when you say data means unstructured facts na siya and figures that have the least impact on a typical manager. Okay, so mga data, any data, di ba? Or facts, so considered na siya as data. And then, ang information, for data to become information, so whatever data ang imong gihatag, mahimo din siyang information. So, it must be contextualized, categorized, calculated, and condensed. So, information thus paints a bigger picture. So, it is data with relevance and purpose. So, mahimo din na yung information. Okay? So, kani, is information, bali, essentially information is found in answers to questions that begin with such words as who, what, where, when, and how many. So, muna ang information. So, si knowledge pod, closely linked to doing and implies know-how and understanding. So, si knowledge, siya mo possessed by each individual na is a product of his experience and encompasses the norms by which he evaluates new inputs from his surroundings. So, mahimo na din itong siyang knowledge. So, the contents of the human mind can be classified into four categories. So, si data, that is symbols, si information, ang katong data that are processed to be useful or provided answers to who, what, where, and when questions. And then, si knowledge, application of data information, so answers how questions. And then, si wisdom is evaluated understanding. So, we need to understand that ang katong pag-process sa data produce information, and then ga-process ang process information produces knowledge and so on. So, bali mo na siya mo link into silang tanan. So, next one is the characteristics of a computer. So, the speed, kung if you're going to discuss about the characteristic, so, ang computer can process data very fast, no? As the rate of millions of instructions per second. So, some calculations that would have taken hours and days to complete otherwise can be completed in a few seconds using the computer. Okay? So, for example, kanang calculation, or kanang mag-generate ka og mga salary slips of thousands of, dagan kayo ng mga empleyado sa isa ka-organization, or mga weather forecasts. Diba? Requires analysis of a large amount of data, no, related to temperature, pressure and humidity of various places. So ingana paspas gid siya. So unlike ko i-manual nimo dugay gid kay ka makakakuha og result. Diba? So ingana pud ang isa na characteristic sa computer, no, ang speed. So the more nimo i-upgrade nimong imong hardware, so the more siya mas paspas. So the accuracy, the computer can accurately give you the computer provides a high degree of accuracy. So, mas accurate gid siya comparison sa manual. So, the computer can accurately give the result of a division of any two numbers up to 10 decimal places. So, syempre, kung gusto gigag accurate na result, so, isa gina siya sa mga characteristics sa computer. So, diligence, so, when used for a longer period of time, the computer does not get tired or fatigued. Diba? So, mainit lagi na siya. So, kailangan di kag air conditioned room o imuhang electric fan. So, mong ginaano mo. Ang mga processor na ito, nagin na siya yung mga kanang CPU fan. No? Nagin na siya dito. Or kanang mga metal na muka-absorb siya sa kainit. So, the more po siya, dili na mo siya yung anon, mainit kaya po siya. Okay? But then, dili siya yung tao na siya ano kaya po ba. So, it can perform long and complex calculation with the same speed and accuracy from the start till the end. Next one is storage capability. Large volumes of data and information can be stored in the computer and also retrieved whenever required. Diba? So muna siya ang responsible na associate hard disk, no? So a limited amount of data can be stored, no? Temporarily in a primary memory, so katong RAM. So ang secondary storage device dai niya, so like nakatong floppy disk katuntag 1.44 MB lang, and a compact disk that can store a large amount of data permanently. Okay? Or katong mismo, katong internal na storage mismo sa computer system na to is ang hard disk. Okay? So, dili pwede ang computer na walay hard disk. So, kailangan siya hard disk. Kaya dito man mismo i-install ang operating system na to. Next is versatility, no? So, the computer is a versatile in nature. So, it can perform different types of tasks with the same ease. So, at the moment, you can use the mga computer to prepare a letter document. And the next moment, you may be plan. siguro mag-una ka, mag-play na ka music, print the documents. So, computers have several limitations too. But computers can only perform tasks that it has been programmed to do. Okay, so kung narapod siya, ano limitation po niya. Pero kung, anong, nasulod rapod sa unsay naka-program niya. So, dili pwede siya nang mag-magic na wala gipabuhat sa iya ha. O wala siya gidesign na. Okay? So, computers cannot do any work without instructions from the user. So, dili gid siya ingon na nag-magic siya. So, kailangan gid siya na reprogram siya tanan. So, it executes instructions as specified by the users and do not take its own decision. So, muagad rin po siya sa isa ka user. So, with this programmer or developer niya. Okay? So, what are some tips to avoid viruses and lessen their impact? So, install antivirus software, no? So, of course, you have to install antivirus software from a reputable vendor. So, you have to update it and use it regularly. Okay? So, in addition to scanning for viruses on a regular basis, install and on access no scanner included in the most antivirus software packages and configure it to start each time you start up for your computer. So this will protect your system by checking for viruses each time you run on an executable file. So kanang of course no kung naka antivirus pag turn on mo sa computer automatic na siya na mag-run. So gina-check niya ang imuhang ano system kung nabay virus running. Okay? So there use a virus scan before you open any new programs or files that may contain executable codes. So this includes kanang mga package software no that you buy from the store as well as any program you might download from the internet. So usahay dana tanan to makuha no kanang mag-download ta or kanang mag-install tag program then sige ra tag next install without reading then naka wala ta kabalo na appeal na din nato siya pagka install. Tingala ka na, gihinay naman kayo ni. That's because muna gihinay siya because the virus is keep on running in your system. Okay, so kung ganun gihinay man siya, so nag-run siya sa imong computer system. So dito niya gikuha niya, 'di ba? Remember the functionality of the random access memory? The more you open an application or any program in your computer, then the RAM or the random access memory temporarily consumes your memory. Okay? Ang memory na naka-install sa imong computer. So, muhinay siya. That's because, bugat man kayang virus dito or nag-appeal siya. So, dito, maski wala ni mo siya gi-open, without knowing, nag-run na dahil siya dito. So, si Rampod, he's di-consume, nag-consume po ang iyang memory dito. So, isa po na siya ng mga indicators na to. So, if you are a member of an online community or chat room, so, you have to be very careful about accepting files or clicking links, no, that you find or that people send you within the community. So, daghan kayo nga na sa Facebook. So, say mga promo-promo, ay kipo what anapis mo. So, you have to ask the person, especially in Messenger, if sila ba'y nagsana na. Uban ka, wala mong may nagsana na. So, please do not open, no. Especially ng DSWD. So, daghan kayo mga pakulo din eh. And then, once i-click niyo muna siya, so, daghan kayo. Masudlan na ni makuha na ni mong files, ni mong accounts, or anything. So, isa na siya ng mga dapat natulikayan. Okay? So, make sure you back up the data or like documents, bookmark files, or important emails, or email messages, and many more on a disk so that in the event of a virus infection, you do not lose valuable work. So, make sure to do backup sa imong mga files. So, pwede ka maka-backup sa imong Google Drive. So, if you have, of course, no, you have an email account, no? Though it's limited, but then, still, it's a good choice na to backup your files. Because tendency, if you do not backup your files, so, kung ma-virusan siya, or dili ma, no, so, it's very, difficult for us to retrieve all the files that you have worked on. So, so kailangan gig backup, no? So, pwede ka mag-backup sa imong USB, pwede ka mag-backup sa CD, or sa imong mga other, accounts. Kung mahimo, dagan ka email accounts para dito nimo sa mga Google Drive or in a OneDrive. So, there, so, that's it. That's a the last part of chapter 1. So that's the introduction to computers. So thank you everyone and good day.